Welcome to Live at 4. Hope you all had a nice long Thanksgiving weekend.
Had a nice long weekend.
What did you do?
Oh, we just ate at home, put up the tree.
Oh, that's nice. I did the same.
So
we went to my brother and sister-in-law's in suburban Chicago, and it was just so nice to all be back together again.
Yeah, it's been a long time.
Yeah. So now back to reality.
Back to reality. Yes. Topping our headlines today, another charge against the man accused of causing a deadly mayhem in Waukesha while students look to return to normal today.
U.S. and other governments are not playing around with the latest COVID variant. We'll take a closer look at what we know and what we don't know about Omicron.
And prosecutors in the Bill Cosby case are going to the nation's highest court, hoping to send him back to prison. We'll explain their argument. But first, let's take a look outside. Not bad for the end of November.
Boy, and no travel problems at all. No. What a gift the weather was over the Thanksgiving weekend.
Absolutely. And November ends on a good note. Dana's in the backyard with more on that. Not too bad out there.
Yeah, not too bad at all, actually. Just a light jacket needed. Now it is, of course, just a little cool outside, a little cloudy, but we have certainly seen far worse ends to November and starts to December. Right now, we're at 42 degrees, a very seasonable afternoon with a light breeze coming in from the south. As we look at our visible cloud track, it has been a cloudy sky for almost all of our Monday. A few pockets of sunshine mixed in, but also some light flurries earlier. Much of the steadier moisture has really been to the northeast, and that is now stretching into parts of Michigan, so really pushing east of us. This isn't something that's going to rotate back around overnight and heading into tomorrow. Overnight, partly cloudy skies. Tomorrow, partly sunny and pretty pleasant. High temperatures will be in the middle 40s for your Tuesday. Quick look at our traffic conditions right now. The Beltline right now not bringing in too many delays. East and westbound actually looks pretty smooth for us currently, and downtown Madison, no hiccups this evening. Throughout Dane County and southwestern Wisconsin, all the major arteries look pretty good. In Rock County, no delays around downtown Janesville. From the Beltline to Janesville, 25 minutes, 16 minutes to get from Middleton to Sauk City, and downtown to Sun Prairie, 17 minutes this evening. We'll take a closer look at what's ahead for the start of December in just a few minutes.
Yeah, I can't believe it's December
in
2 days. All right, Dana, thank you. First at 4, there are now 6 felony charges filed against Darrell Brooks, the man accused of driving his SUV through the Waukesha Christmas parade last Sunday.
Prosecutors added another first-degree intentional homicide count after an 8-year-old boy died from his injuries. Jackson Sparks' family announced his death in a social media post the same day Brooks was initially charged, and prosecutors told the court they plan to add a count accordingly. Today's amended complaint quoted Sparks' autopsy, which showed he died from brain injuries and blunt force trauma to the head. More than 60 other people were hurt during the parade, including more than a dozen children. Many of those children go to school in Waukesha, where today the school district hoped to offer them a sense of normal.
Waukesha schools reopened with some additional staffing, hoping to ensure that students feel safe and supported. Our Brady Mallory joins us now with a look at how they did that. Brady?
Our classes were canceled last week, and district leaders are calling today's return a soft start. Schools started the day with acknowledging what happened at the parade. The superintendent didn't say how many kids were involved in the parade, but says it was a substantial number. As they return to school, there are counselors and psychologists available, and they will be there as needed. About 250 kids had counseling sessions today. The goal is to make this first week back as easy as possible for them.
We had kids in school today with the bumps and bruises, some broken bones and things like that who were able to return. We've had, you know, kids with a variety level of need and injury that they experienced. And so we'll be working through those plans with families in the days ahead to make sure that those kids can access their education and support when they're ready.
Dr. Cook says the kids are still processing what happened, and they have a lot of questions. We also learned that the child who died was not a Waukesha student. District leaders say they are getting a lot of calls from local companies that want to help. And if you want to help, they say the best thing to do is to contact the school district.
Brady, thank you. Prosecutors asked the U.S. Supreme Court to review the decision that overturned Bill Cosby's conviction. In a petition filed today, they wrote that courts should not equate a supposed promise made by a former prosecutor to lifetime immunity. immunity. They believe the Pennsylvania Supreme Court made an error when it overturned Cosby's conviction in June and released the 84-year-old actor from prison. The state's high court says Cosby relied on a promise he would never be charged when he gave damaging testimony that was later used against him. Cosby's accused of drugging and molesting a woman in 2004. He spent nearly 3 years in prison.
A 29-year-old man faces a first-degree intentional homicide charge after a shooting at a Blooming Grove gas station yesterday. The man who allegedly shot and killed another person at a gas station on the corner of Milwaukee Street and North Wallbridge Avenue was arrested Sunday. The Dane County Sheriff's Office named the man in a news release, but News 3 has chosen not to publish his name until formal charges are filed. The name of the shooting victim has not been released.
Concerns on the latest coronavirus variant are mounting as the holiday season is upon us.
Naomi Ruckham has more on why the Omicron variant is raising concern.
As more countries report cases of the new coronavirus variant Omicron, there are concerns about whether it's more contagious and virulent than the Delta variant.
This thing has mutated like crazy. There's at least 30 mutations in the spike protein. This is like way more than any other variant.
Those mutations could make it easier for the virus to infect the cells. Well, Dr. Robert Murphy is an infectious disease specialist at Northwestern Medicine.
If you look at the data, it does look like it's most likely transmitting easier than Delta. We don't know if it's really any worse as far as disease progression or death or hospitalization. So it may be very similar to what we saw with Delta, but all this really has to play out, and it's going to take us probably at least 1 to 2 weeks.
Another concern, how effective current vaccines will be against the new variant, which is now being studied.
It's most likely that the current vaccines do offer some kind of protection.
How many more of these variants could there be in our future?
It's going to be endless until everybody's vaccinated.
Experts agree a worldwide vaccination effort is critical to stop this pandemic because the longer it goes on, the more likely the virus can mutate. Naomi Ruckham, CBS News, New York.
Whether you're a member of the medical community or a member of the general public, you likely have more questions than answers for what is Omicron. How does it respond to vaccines? Right now, it's too soon to say, but there are things we do know. The COVID variant was discovered a few weeks ago in Botswana. Officials say they don't know quite yet how contagious it is or how it responds to vaccines, but they say for now, masking and getting vaccinated are still our best line of defense.
The everyday person can still rest assured that a lot of the things that we have been doing for preventing spread are still effective.
UW Health also regularly updates its COVID variant tracker. You can find the link to follow along on our website, channel3000.com.
President Biden spent the morning huddled with his COVID response team to talk about the Omicron variant. Today is the first day of travel restrictions in the United States, keeping non-U.S. citizens from entering the country from South Africa and seven other nations. But the variant has spread well beyond Southern Africa, reaching at least 14 countries, including our neighbor to the north, Canada.
My team is already working with officials at Pfizer and Moderna and Johnson & Johnson to develop contingency plans for vaccines or boosters if needed.
Vaccine manufacturers say it will take about 2 weeks to learn whether or not their drugs work against Omicron. Despite that, health officials say now is the time to get vaccinated or boosted.
An improvement project on a busy Beloit Road corridor got underway this morning. Changes are being made to address safety concerns on Cranston Road between Milwaukee and Chaupière Roads. The changes are designed to slow down traffic and reduce accidents throughout the area. There may be minor closures on side roads. Those traffic impacts will be announced on the city of Beloit Public Works Facebook page. The project is expected to be completed by the end of next month, weather permitting.
Afghan women staying at Fort McCoy who recently became new mothers are now being offered newborn classes. The first welcome baby class was held at Fort McCoy's Women's Resource Center earlier this month. The class discusses postpartum depression, meditation, soothing a crying baby, nutrition, and hygiene. Clinical social worker Julia Yeary, who taught the class, says living in a war-torn country plus the stress of the evacuation puts these new moms at higher risk of postpartum depression. Yeary says the hope is the classes will help the new moms feel supported while they navigate the resettlement process here in America.
Six sections of the AIDS Memorial quilt are now being displayed at the Beloit Public Library as part of World AIDS Day, which is being observed on Wednesday. The quilt is meant as a commemoration of the more than 700,000 American lives lost to AIDS since the first cases were reported in the U.S. 40 years ago this year. The library worked together with the National AIDS Memorial to get the sections of the quilt for display, which features panels with Wisconsin connections and made to honor and remember the names of friends and loved ones lost to AIDS. One panel includes a tribute to Beloit College alum Michael Reisenberg, who died as a result of the disease in 1993.
There are 50,000 panels weighing 54 tons. It's so large that you can't even put it out on the National Mall anymore. It doesn't fit. And each panel was made by the friends and family of loved ones who have died of AIDS.
Today, HIV is on the rise, particularly among young people, communities of color, and in southern states. Quilt displays are used to raise greater awareness about the story of AIDS and prevention, treatments, and resources available within the community.
The White House is ready for the holidays. First Lady Jill Biden unveiled this year's holiday theme and decor titled Gifts from the Heart, inspired in part by the challenges of the pandemic. The display includes 41 Christmas trees, about 6,000 feet of ribbon, 300 candles, more than 10,000 ornaments, and nearly 79,000 holiday lights.
Sounds like your house, Susan.
I know. Less is not more. The First Lady was joined by a number of National Guard members and their families today to enjoy the festivities. Well, four professional Madison area women and a student are the winners of this year's first annual Amy's.
Madison Magazine and News 3 Now are honoring those award winners in a cover story in the magazine and a special program this evening.
The winners embody the work and the spirit of entrepreneur Amy Gannon, who you may recall. Amy and her 13-year-old daughter tragically died in a helicopter accident when they were on vacation in Hawaii 2 years ago. Annie Vang is one of the honorees. She grew up in Wisconsin, the child of Hmong immigrants. Annie says she wanted to work as a computer programmer all her life, but knew early on that was going to be a challenge. But I understand you asked your teacher if you could do something with computers for a living.
Because I loved like computers so much, I took like every computer class possible up until like freshman year of high school. Mm-hmm. And I asked my teacher, like, I really wanted to make those things. And she told me, like, I would not be successful because I was not a boy and I was not a genius. And I felt really sad, I was really embarrassed. And I actually just thought maybe that just wasn't for me.
Well, it certainly was for her. You'll see tonight Annie got a degree in web development and she created two successful phone apps to translate the Hmong language.
You can hear her story and those of the other women who turned life and professional challenges into successful careers tonight, reaching higher, the Amy's air tonight at 6:30, right after News 3 Now at 6. I can't wait to see this.
I think you'll be very inspired.
Yeah. Absolutely. Still to come at 4, just when we thought we were seeing some light at the end of the COVID tunnel, a new variant is causing concern.
We'll get some advice on dealing with more bad COVID news and what you can do to cope. That's when Live at 4 continues. We'll be right back.
You're watching News 3 Now, Live at 4.
In Wisconsin, demand for nurses is heating up. With pressure rising to fill that shortage, Herzing University offers you a path to a BSN degree with no wait lists.
I'm possible at Herzing.
Call or click today.
Do you suffer from erectile dysfunction? Peak Performance for Men uses an advanced form of acoustic wave therapy, restoring normal and natural functionability where it counts most. Call now and receive an ultrasound, your initial consultation, all for free. Call Peak Performance for Men today.
Black Friday, get holiday ready with Ford. America's best-selling trucks are here, and capable SUVs are rolling out. Get great offers on the Ford that's right for you, like Ford Explorer, America's all-time best-selling SUV, and Ford F-Series, America's best-selling trucks for 44 years straight. So this Black Friday, get holiday ready with Ford. Right now, get 0% financing for 60 months, plus $500 bonus cash on Ford F-150. See your local Ford dealer today.
You protected our rights, preserved our freedom. You may have even risked your life for us. Now, it's our turn to fight for you. Your local Wisconsin emergency, energy, and housing assistance providers, and the Keep Wisconsin Warm Cool Fund reward the service of our veterans with rental and energy support in their time of crisis. Apply today to get the fresh start you've earned.
These are the faces that smile so wide at the friends and staff who are by their side, where life is lived with a feeling of pride on every bump of life's great ride that comes from the care that sweetens the air that lives in the house that angels built. Attic Angel Community, independent homes and four levels of assisted living built with the help of angels.
This is why you want Farmers Claim forgiveness. Your home premium won't go up just because of this.
Wow, that's something.
You get a whole lot of something with Farmers Policy Perks. Get a quote today.
We are Farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
McGann Furniture in Baraboo has a question for you. Have you ever bought a piece of furniture in a box and then had to put it together yourself? We know, it's not fun. At McGann's, everything is professionally inspected and assembled before pickup or delivery. Goodbye headaches, and there's no extra charge for assembly. And remember, at McGann's, we don't inflate prices only to mark them down for a sale. Stop in soon and discover the difference. You'll be glad you did. McGann Furniture, downtown Baraboo.
To the thousands of Herzing University nursing and healthcare alumni, for your tireless commitment, and to all of your brave colleagues across America, we say thank you.
I'm possible at Herzing.
Welcome back, everyone. Merriam-Webster has picked the one word it believes represents 2021.
And that word is vaccine. Today, the publisher announced vaccine as its official 2021 Word of the Year. Merriam-Webster says the choice highlights the dual discussion surrounding vaccinations this year, how the COVID-19 vaccine was seen as both a promising medical solution and a source of political argument and division. This is the second year Merriam-Webster has made a coronavirus-influenced pick. Pandemic was its 2020 Word of the Year.
Canada's maple syrup industry is in a sticky situation. The Quebec maple syrup producers say they are tapping into reserves to deal with supply strains. The government-supported organization says it is releasing about 50 million pounds of syrup, almost half of its stockpile. Quebec produces about 73% of all of the maple syrup in the world. This year, about 133 million pounds were harvested, which is about the average, but sales have risen 21% compared to last year, and that is what is leading to the shortage.
What next? Well, the Better Business Bureau is reminding Americans that scammers are ramping up for the holiday season. The BBB recently released its list of top 12 scams of Christmas. They say criminals use emails and social media to facilitate most of the scams, but social media is where people are the most vulnerable. The top three scams on the list center on social media platforms. The BBB also warns consumers to avoid misleading ads, gift exchanges, and holiday apps. They also point out scams that appear every year during the holidays, like fake charities, fake shipping notifications, look-alike websites, and puppy scams.
Air travel is almost back to pre-pandemic levels, at least on holidays. The Transportation Security Administration screened 2.4 million people yesterday. That is the busiest day since the pandemic began. It's also double the number of people who passed through airports last year. The TSA screened almost 21 million people over the entire Thanksgiving. Thanksgiving holiday weekend.
Stocks recouped some of Friday's massive losses after President Biden said the new COVID variant is not a cause for panic. The Dow Industrials gained 236 points, closing at 35,135. The NASDAQ was up 291 points. The S&P 500 added 60. Well, Thanksgiving week was going quite well until the markets were spooked on Friday by the rise of the new COVID variant in Africa.
Omicron, of course, is the new variant of concern, and experts say it will likely be here soon.
So how do we handle our emotions over this? Our happiness expert, Dr. Christine Whelan from UW-Madison, is back with us. Welcome back.
Hi, Christine.
Hope you had a good Thanksgiving.
Hi there. Great to see you. Happy Thanksgiving.
Yep, you too. So there's no reason to panic over this, according to the president.
Right. So there is this new variant of concern, Omicron, and the real answer is we just don't know yet, right? So there's no reason to panic. And from my perspective, as somebody who talks about happiness and well-being, really, we have a very big mental health toolkit when it comes to pandemics, and now is the time to pull what we need to pull. So panicking is not going to help, right? We know the things we need to do. We need to get vaccinated. We need to take the precautions, get tested if we feel sick. But the other thing is that we don't control this in terms of the ideas in our head. So if we are thinking negatively, that's not going to change anything. Instead, the idea would be to take an abundance mindset rather than a scarcity mindset. Think of the good things that might happen. Think positively. Have hope, which is not to say put a smiley face on things. It just means focus on the positive and be in the present moment when you can.
It might bring back a little bit of anxiety from previous surges, though. You know, there's a kind of a feeling of, oh boy,
here we go again,
and we're never going to get out of this. It's difficult to maintain that positive, abundant mindset.
Absolutely. We are all exhausted. So one of the big words of 2021 was languishing, that feeling of just utter exhaustion and pandemic fatigue, right? We've been dealing with this for a long time. This is where, when we know, though, that we can take the precautions that we need to take, having that sense that we're going to carry on with our lives and be hopeful until we know that we have to make a change is a really good thing. But what I'm trying to do is continue to make plans. And I have to say, for the last couple of years now, though, I've been holding those plans fairly loosely, watching the news and seeing what happens, but not taking a doomsday approach until I know things have to change.
That's very reassuring. It's a good idea.
And I think we've sort of adapted it 20 months into this thing. It's like, okay, this is what we have to do to stay healthy.
Mm-hmm.
It is. And we also do have to remember to stay mentally and socially healthy as well, because having lots of isolation and lockdowns, we may need those for public health reasons, but hopefully not. Hopefully we can continue to see ourselves as whole people who are in community with others and really look ahead to a really happy and healthy holiday season.
Yeah, just think that this too shall pass, because everything does. What is the scarcity mindset you mentioned?
So this idea of scarcity is something that we really have to combat this holiday season. We're worried that there aren't going to be enough toys to give to the kids. We're worried that our gifts aren't going to arrive on time because they'll be on shipping containers. So we have this idea that I've got to get what I need and I'll elbow you out of the way to get it. That's a scarcity mindset, an us versus them kind of mindset. And that tends to make us less happy than an abundance mindset, saying, you know what, there's going to be enough for all of us. If we have to wait a little longer for something to arrive, that's okay too. And as we think about a new variant, we can have an abundance of hope for the future that we want to take care of ourselves and take care of our loved ones and our community by being safe and doing the right thing.
Abundance of hope for the future. I like
love that abundance mindset. That's great.
Christine, thanks for being with us today.
Thank you. And here's to an abundant holiday season.
Absolutely.
Yes. Good to see you. See you soon.
Well, in case you missed it was Tony and Gaga, two musical legends, one legendary concert.
We'll have the highlights from last night's CBS special broadcast of the concert coming up after Dana's First Warn Forecast.
Vitense Golfland Golf Suites. Practice in a golf range in comfort year-round. Enjoy the practice and entertainment experience with friendly VIP grill and bar service, heated tee areas, comfortable overhead heated seating, music, and HD TVs. Only at Vitense Golfland.
Hello, I'm Roman Ryan of Ryan Funeral Homes. As a locally owned and operated funeral home, it's important to know that not all funeral homes are the same.
Some other Madison area funeral homes are actually owned by corporations based outside of the United States. A corporately owned funeral home is focused on the bottom line, making services more costly. We have served local families for more than 80 years, and our priority is investing in the community and your family.
In your time of need, Ryan Funeral Homes are here for you.
Your eyes, beautiful on the outside, but if you have diabetes, there can be some not-so-pretty stuff going on inside. It's true. With diabetic retinopathy, excess sugar can damage blood vessels, causing vision loss or even blindness. So remember this. Now is the time to get your eyes checked. Eye care is important to your long-term diabetes management. See a path forward with actions and treatments that may help your eyes and protect against vision loss. Visit NowIC.com and take control of your sight.
An official message from Medicare.
Did you try it yet?
Comparing plans?
Oh, yeah, they sure can change year to year.
I found lower premiums.
And lower prescription costs.
That'll save you money. So, Mark?
On Medicare.gov now.
Open enrollment ends December 7th.
Use the plan finder at Medicare.gov to compare Medicare health and prescription plans.
Comparing plans really pays.
Paid for by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services.
It's time to choose a Medicare plan. So why not choose a five-star Medicare Advantage HMO plan from Quartz? Starting as low as $0 per month, including medical, hospital, and prescriptions, and dental, vision, and hearing aid benefits. Learn more. Call us today to find a plan that fits your budget and your lifestyle. Quartz offers the region's top-rated Medicare Advantage plans, and they're now even more exciting. New for 2022, the Quartz Cash Card gives you the freedom to spend up to $460 annually on a variety of health-related products and services. And Quartz gives you access to an all-star team of high-quality providers featuring UW Health, giving you the five-star treatment you deserve. Because at Quartz, you're the star of our five-star Medicare Advantage plans. Don't wait. Call now to get plan details from Quartz or speak with one of our enrollment specialists today.
Vitens Golfland now offers two indoor golf and multi-sport simulator suites. Play over 100 championship golf courses with unmatched golf swing data and visualization. Or play other sports and games using real sports equipment. The Vitens Golfland simulator suites provides a fun indoor entertainment experience.
Take a look at this. 11-month-old Wang Yuli hasn't even nailed walking yet. And here she is ready, taking on the internet by storm. Her parents say they hope to teach her to ski. We're surprised to see the little one master balancing on a snowboard all on her own. Wrapped in protective gear, the toddler is smoothly sliding downhill and into our hearts.
Oh, buddy. And look at the smile on her face.
11 months old.
Smart. That, the earlier the better.
Yeah,
that is a really great, oh, she is priceless. Well, hundreds of people gathered in Times Square in New York City yesterday for a tribute dedicated to the late composer and lyricist Stephen Sondheim, who died suddenly on Friday at the age of 91. Oh, I hate to have that music stop. You could listen to that all day. Among the attendees was the creator of Hamilton, actor and composer Lin-Manuel Miranda. He gave a moving speech dedicated to Sondheim. Singers Josh Groban and Sarah Bareilles joined in the chorus to perform Sunday, the final act in Sondheim's 1984 Pulitzer Award-winning musical, Sunday in the Park with George.
What a genius he was.
Yeah, that is such a beautiful. Now, are these all Broadway people, too?
I think the leads are.
Yeah. Oh, what a beautiful moment.
You'd be missed, that's for sure. All right, time now for weather. Dana's singing a warmer tune in the weather department.
A little bit, yeah. We're trending a little mild, actually, for the next several days. Not a big jump up in our temperatures, but we might see the 50s a few times for the start of December. Here's a beautiful look at our sunset right now. A little bit of cloud coverage still hanging out in the sky. We'll take a closer look at your full 10-day right after the break.
Safe, fun. I wanted it all when we needed daytime care for mom. Oh, Grace's new adult day center is so nice. Now she goes twice a week while I'm at work and loves it.
A Grace, caring every step of the way.
We love our new home. Lots of windows, great light.
But the birds. They're back.
Yes, I hear them.
Uh-oh.
Why are these birds so angry?
At least Geico makes bundling our home and car insurance easy.
We save a lot.
I'm going.
Hurry.
For bundling made easy, go to geico.com.
Guys, if you're suffering from erectile dysfunction, Peak Performance for Men has a natural solution that can help you today. That's right. Stop wasting money on pills and inferior technology that hurts and just masks your ED. Fix it for good. The best part? Our ED treatment is non-invasive, painless, and you can get back to your natural functionability after just a few short in-office sessions. Call us today and mention this ad, and your initial consultation is free.
We are Madison's trusted specialist and only national erectile dysfunction provider. Call Peak Performance for Men today.
Hey, guys.
Hey, Dad.
You ready?
This holiday, U.S. Cellular is doing a little something extra to keep everyone connected. Right now, choose any phone from any brand at any of our stores for free. Plus, save big with unlimited data for our best price of the season, just $30 a month. Now that's a deal to cheer about. Feel the locally grown joy from U.S. Cellular, America's locally grown wireless.
Stanley Steamer loves Madison, Wisconsin. I'm Paul Ashick, local owner of Stanley Steamer here in Madison. We've been proudly cleaning your homes and businesses for over 30 years and will continue to keep your carpet, upholstery, area rugs, hard floors, and air ducts clean for many more. We strive to provide the best quality in both the services we provide and the equipment we use. That's why you've trusted us to keep Madison and southwestern Wisconsin homes cleaner, healthier, and more beautiful place to live. Call and book a cleaning today.
Stanley Steamer, it's your home cleaner.
With Dad's arthritis, he struggles with housework and bathing, so I called a Grace. Yes, a Grace. With their age-at-home service, Dad gets the help he needs to stay independent at home. A Grace, caring every step of the way.
News 3 Now First Warn Weather is brought to you by Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor.
Discover a shopping and design experience as comfortable as the furniture. Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor. Schedule your free design consultation today.
As stated earlier, November is ending on a good note for us. Still a little cloudy outside right now, but temperature-wise, close to average today in the low 40s with a light breeze coming in from the south. We saw a little light flurry action for us in Dane County and towards the Dells. Did see a little more of a light mixed precipitation earlier, but notice some steadier snowfall to the north towards Green Bay. That's all pulling east now into Michigan. Nothing that's expected to wrap back around and impact us as we look ahead to your Tuesday. In fact, Tuesday should be mild outside, and much of the 10-day forecast overall trending above average, a mild trend for the start of December. A few opportunities for some more mixed precipitation, mainly early in the day on Wednesday, so it could be a little slippery outside early Wednesday morning. Doesn't look like it's going to lead to much, but we could be impacted a little bit early Wednesday. Our next opportunity for snow accumulation, that builds in on Sunday. Again, minor accumulations expected, but it could be a little bit for us coming through on Sunday. So right now we're still mostly cloudy. Skies will become partly cloudy overnight with temperatures early Tuesday morning dropping below freezing yet again into the upper 20s for overnight lows. Afternoon high temperatures for Tuesday afternoon landing in the mid to low 40s. So still trending pretty close to average, if not a little bit above, to see the mid 40s just south of Madison and Dane County. This is that impact for us early Wednesday morning. Just after midnight, we'll start to see possibly a few light freezing rain or snow or rain spots with these temperatures pretty close to freezing. We'll see a little mixed precip for early on Wednesday. Notice it's not a lot passing through, but just a little bit of moisture can slow things down early in the day. This likely wraps up in the morning before noon with high temperatures in the afternoon, a little bit of clearing later in the day, landing close to 50 degrees for Wednesday. So there's that mild spell for us for the middle of the week. And you can see as we look ahead into next week and the start of December, how this warming trend just shifts over the entire country. So in the 6 to 10 day outlook, it's mainly anchored in the southwest that starts to pull a little further east into the Midwest, starting to become a little more likely into the middle of December at that point, our 8 to 14 day outlook that we're trending above average. For tomorrow, partly sunny skies, so pleasant outside, high temperatures in the middle 40s. We'll be close to 50 for Wednesday and for Thursday, with sunshine expected for most of our afternoons. But we are going to have, again, a few opportunities, possibly for a little mix early Wednesday, and possibly some flurries Thursday night. With those high temperatures, though, in the 40s and 50s, just not concerned about anything causing too much of a mess for us. Sunday will be our opportunity for a little accumulating snow, still trending in the lower amounts for us for Sunday. Not a major event passing through. It is going to be a little cooler for the start of next week, generally in the 30s, mid to low 30s for afternoon highs, but still just a little bit above average when we have those days starting to creep up into the upper 30s and overnight lows trending in the 20s.
December 1st,
50 degrees. 50 degrees. How about that? I don't want to hear any complaining, guys.
Nobody's complaining. All right, Dana, thank you.
Thanks, Dana.
A special broadcast of Tony Bennett and Lady Gaga performing in one of the 95-year-old legend's final two shows in August aired last night here on CBS.
They took place at New York City's Radio City Music Hall just 6 months after Bennett's family revealed he had Alzheimer's disease.
Vlad Duthier has more.
She gets too hungry for dinner at 8.
It was as if Tony Bennett had never left the stage. The legendary crooner, alongside Lady Gaga, charmed and delighted during Sunday night's concert special.
That's why this lady, I'm a tramp.
Gaga told Anderson Cooper the performances were especially meaningful in an interview for CBS's 60 Minutes last month. They took place just 6 months after Bennett's family revealed he had Alzheimer's disease.
Hey, Tony.
That's the first time that Tony said my name in a long time.
Really?
In all the weeks leading up to it, he hadn't said your name.
Wow.
I had to keep it together because we had a sold-out show and I have a job to do. But I'll tell you, when I walked out on that stage and he said it's Lady Gaga, my friend saw me.
Though I'm not a great romancer.
The special was both a tribute to Bennett's more than 70-year career. And a celebration of his 95th birthday.
Fill my heart with song. Let me sing forevermore.
Bennett sang classics like Fly Me to the Moon, receiving numerous standing ovations from audiences.
Wow. What a great audience.
I think he really pushed through something to give the world the gift of knowing that things can change and you can still be magnificent.
Your golden sun will shine for me.
That was so remarkable.
What a gift indeed.
Absolutely. And you should really watch the 60 Minutes interview with him, Anderson Cooper's interview, if you have an opportunity. Tony Bennett may be done with touring, but he is still being recognized for his talents.
He and Lady Gaga are up for 6 Grammy Awards for their album of Cole Porter duets, Love for Sale. A treasure.
Yeah.
An American treasure. Well, Cyber Monday is well underway. Amazon fulfillment centers, machines, and products are moving nonstop. We'll take a look at what could be a record-breaking shopping day.
And then coming up next hour at 5, with the officer involved shooting last night, our Naomi Coles tells us about mental health training in the Madison Police Department.
If you get hurt in an accident, do you know who to call?
Call Gruber Law Offices.
Everybody knows that.
They'll start working on your case right away.
Everybody knows that.
Hurt in an accident?
Everybody knows you call Gruber Law Offices.
One call, that's all.
This Black Friday, get holiday ready with Ford. America's best-selling trucks are here, and capable SUVs are rolling out. Get great offers on the Ford that's right for you. Like Ford Explorer, America's all-time best-selling SUV. And Ford F-Series, America's best-selling trucks for 44 years straight. So this Black Friday, get holiday ready with Ford. Now lease America's all-time best-selling SUV, Ford Explorer, for just $389 a month. Only at your local Ford dealer.
To be a thriver with metastatic breast cancer means asking for what we want and need, and we need more time. So we want Kisqali. Women are living longer than ever before with Kisqali. When taken with an aromatase inhibitor or fulvestrant in postmenopausal women with HR-positive, HER2-negative metastatic breast cancer, Kisqali is a pill that's significantly more effective at delaying disease progression versus an aromatase inhibitor or fulvestrant alone. Kisqali can cause lung problems or an abnormal heartbeat, which can lead to death. It can cause serious skin reactions, liver problems, and low white blood cell counts that may result in severe infections. Tell your doctor right away if you have new or worsening symptoms, including breathing problems, cough, chest pain, a change in your heartbeat, dizziness, yellowing of the skin or eyes, dark urine, tiredness, loss of appetite, abdomen pain, bleeding, bruising, fever, chills, or other symptoms of an infection, a severe or worsening rash, are or plan to become pregnant or breastfeeding. Avoid grapefruit during treatment. Ask your doctor about living longer with Kisqali.
We're here at Ho-Chunk Gaming Madison. Tom, people are loving this place.
They sure are, Jerry. Let's go see who Tina's chatting with now.
Thanks, guys. Looks like we have some beautiful ladies joining us. What are you up to tonight, girls?
Girls' night.
We're getting some drinks.
I want to win that car.
Sounds great. Are you feeling lucky? What's your favorite slot machine? To you guys.
Looks like those ladies are on a mission.
Oh, it's about to go down.
Ho-Chunk Gaming Madison.
One call, that's all.
One call, that's all means that you call Gruber Law Offices and your case is handled. You don't have to worry about anything anymore. They take care of you completely.
One call, that's all.
Tonight at 5, we're finding out what type of crisis response training Madison officers have after one officer fired his gun during a suicide incident yesterday.
Expect nice weather for the last day of November with even milder weather on the way as we start December. My forecast at 5.
And then immediately following News 3 at 6, join me for the first annual Amy's, an award show honoring female entrepreneurs in memory of Amy Gannon and her daughter Jocelyn. See you tonight after News 3 Now at 6.
Let's spin the old weather satellite. We end up in, where do we at? Denver, Colorado. It's the state capital in Colorado. It's sunny and warm there.
It's a beautiful day in Colorado. That's nice. Not quite as nice as our capital,
no,
but still nice.
It's still nice. Well, Cyber Monday is traditionally the biggest online shopping day of the year.
But supply chain issues could make some holiday gifts difficult to get.
Laura Podesta has more.
The search for Cyber Monday deals is underway following a busy weekend of online shopping. Top-selling products include toys, books, video games, and appliances. Adobe Analytics says today retailers are offering big discounts on televisions.
If you're looking to make that upgrade to a new TV, then Cyber Monday is going to be your day for that.
TVs and thousands of other products are being handled at Amazon fulfillment centers. This one in New Jersey is 28 football fields in length, and there are hundreds more like it worldwide.
There are more than 750,000 employees working across our operations buildings.
Amazon says globally, customers ordered 1,600 products per second on Black Friday, and today could be even busier. Retail analysts predict online shoppers will spend a record $11.3 billion on Cyber Monday. But a shipping bottleneck and trucking delays are making it difficult for retailers to deliver. Adobe Analytics says out-of-stock messages in November are up 124% from pre-pandemic levels. The most common out-of-stock items are appliances, electronics, housekeeping supplies, and home and garden items.
We've seen that consumers are planning ahead. They started earlier in terms of their shopping.
Experts say shoppers looking for something specific should buy it now because it might not be around long. Laura Podesta, CBS News, Robbinsville, New Jersey.
FedEx and the U.S. Postal Service say you need to ship by December 15th if you want to make sure that your package arrives in time for Christmas.
Did you buy anything today?
No, I didn't,
no,
actually.
I didn't.
Did you?
No, I didn't either. All right, still to come at 4, if you go by the box office numbers, a trip to the movies over Thanksgiving weekend was a family affair.
When we come back, our film critic Will Loper has the numbers and advice on what to watch coming up. That's when Live at 4 continues. We'll be right back.
What does it mean to fight for what's right?
To us, it means helping accident victims get their lives back to normal again. Habish, Habish, and Rotier. We fight for what's right.
These are the faces that smile so wide at the friends and staff who are by their side, where life is lived with a feeling of pride on every bump of life's great ride that comes from the care that sweetens the air that lives in the house that angels built. Attic Angel Community. Independent homes and four levels of assisted living built with the help of angels.
This is Connie Ryan of Ryan Funeral Homes. While things have changed, it's still necessary for families to stay connected. And when it comes to the loss of a loved one, it's important to process and grieve and honor your loved one in a way that keeps everyone safe. We're doing this through intimate services and private virtual streaming so your family can be part of the service no matter where they are. Ryan Funeral Homes are here with your safety in mind and compassionate care in your time of need.
Feeling trapped by your expensive cell phone plan? Here's the key. Switch to Consumer Cellular. Keep your phone and number with the same great coverage as the big carriers. Escape to a no-contract $20 a month plan with talk, text, and data. It's easy to connect with our award-winning customer support team. No sleight of hand is required. Call, go online, or visit Target to get your new SIM card or phone today.
Those drops you'll see probably won't touch me. I want to stay for the holidays.
If your dry eye symptoms keep coming back,
You may need to target information.
Over-the-counter eye drops typically work by lubricating the eyes and may provide temporary relief. Xiidra works differently, targeting inflammation that can cause dry eye disease. It can provide lasting relief. Xiidra is the only FDA-approved non-steroid eye drop specifically for the signs and symptoms of dry eye disease. One drop in each eye twice a day. Don't use if you are allergic to Xiidra. Common side effects include eye irritation, discomfort, or blurred vision when applied to the eye, and unusual taste sensation. Don't touch container tip to your eye or any surface. After using Xiidra, wait 15 minutes before reinserting contacts.
Eyes to relieve symptoms of crease. Xiidra can bring lasting relief.
This holiday, ask your doctor about Xiidra.
When you're the victim of an accident, it can feel like the weight of the entire world is on your shoulders. Why not let us take that crippling burden off your back? Habish, Habish, and Rotier. We fight for what's right.
A few quick traffic notes for us right now. Well, the Beltline doesn't look too bad. We do have this section of Highway 30 right now, just outside or just west of Highway 39 and 90. The eastbound side moving quite slowly. There are no lanes closed right now. I just checked. It looks like just the right shoulder is closed, but you can see those delays extending all the way back to 51, stretching back from 39 and 90. So again, that's Highway 30 eastbound, just northeast of downtown. Otherwise, the Beltline east and westbound, no major delays for us this evening, and throughout the major roadways for us in southwestern Wisconsin, we're not seeing any other hiccups for us right now. That's a quick look at traffic.
All right, Jenna, thank you. A lot of people put up Christmas lights over the weekend, including this house in central Germany that includes more than 70,000 lights. The owners say it all started years ago with a single string of lights in the front garden. But as you can see, it's grown into a display that attracts crowds from all over the region. And not only are there lights, visitors get to enjoy sausages, lemonade, and mulled wine, with all the proceeds going to help animals.
If you have a great house out there, send us a picture. We'll put it online.
Absolutely.
Before. I'd love to see people's decorations.
Doesn't have to look like that. But we'll take it. All right, many people spend part of their long holiday weekend at the movies, and it seems to have been a family affair.
Our Will Loper tells us what to watch and what to skip at home and in the theaters in the Loper Report.
Hey, Mark and Susan. Families turned out for Disney's newest Encanto, which led the box office with $40 million over the five-day Thanksgiving weekend.
I'm not super strong like Luisa.
The donkey's got out again.
On it! Or effortlessly perfect like Senorita Perfecta Isabella. The
hope you're just as special as anyone else in this family.
Mirabelle is the only one in her family without a magical power, but soon she may be their only hope.
Mirabelle, the fate of the family is gonna come down to you.
I can't do this.
Let me help you. The rats told me everything. Don't eat those.
The film is beautifully animated and has a touching story that kids and families will enjoy. And apparently all it takes to get adult moviegoers back in theaters is a little Italian melodrama. House of Gucci opened at number 3 in theaters.
It was a name that sounded so sweet, so seductive.
Lady Gaga stars as Patrizia, who marries into the Gucci family and shows each family member as they crave more power and money. From Jared Leto as Paolo to Adam Driver as Maurizio.
It is an empire.
You can help the family. Gucci is not exciting, and everybody knows it.
At least it's my name, sweetie.
Our name. Sweetie.
Insane, over-the-top Italian accents aside, the film is an entertaining watch from start to finish, even if the story itself will leave you feeling pretty crummy.
I subscribe to unconventional punishment.
Over on streaming services, newly streaming on Netflix is the documentary 14 Peaks.
There are only 14 mountains in the world higher than 8,000 meters.
The fastest time to climb all the 14 was 7 years.
A Nepali mountaineer sets out to summit 14 mountains in 7 months.
It doesn't matter where you come from. You can show the world nothing is impossible.
And new on Netflix Wednesday is the film The Power of the Dog.
What you doing? Getting mixed up with her.
You are marvelous, Rose. We were married someday.
Benedict Cumberbatch stars as a cruel rancher, tormenting his brother's new wife and her son.
He's just a man, Peter. Only another man.
Another season of the strange but compelling How To with John Wilson is streaming on HBO Max.
Hey, New York. There's a lot of stuff that happened since the last season of the show ended. You got really good at cutting your own hair.
An awkward man goes around New York making observations.
New York looks more interesting right now than it ever has before.
And new on Hulu tomorrow, see Hansel and Gretel's dream home come to life with Candified.
We have just 6 weeks to create a life-size, fully functional holiday candy house.
The whole house.
The whole house.
It's going to be covered in candy.
For Live at 4, I'm Will Loper.
I want to see all of it.
It's a variety.
Yeah. That's great.
John Wilson, you should check that out.
That's funny?
He's pretty good.
Okay, great.
All right, we'll have a final check of your forecast coming up.
What makes Salonpas arthritis gel so good for arthritis pain? Salonpas contains the most prescribed topical pain relief ingredient. It's clinically proven, reduces inflammation, and comes in original prescription strength. Salonpas, it's good medicine.
Clean, safe, fun. I was hoping daytime care for mom would be like that. O'Grace's new center is so nice. Now, caring for mom is so much easier.
It's easier to manage my chemo side effects since O'Grace Supportive Care came to see me. It was O'Grace, but it wasn't hospice.
When you're ready for hospice, you want O'Grace. They helped make my dad's last weeks comfortable, calm. It was beautiful.
O'Grace, caring every step of the way.
Those brave men and women of our armed forces, generations of them. Why should today's burdens fall back onto them? They were there for us. Now let's be there for them. Your local Wisconsin energy providers and the Keep Wisconsin Warm Cool Fund are working together to deliver Wisconsin veterans in crisis heat, power, and help staying in their home. But they can't do it alone. Call to donate today.
Nothing
beats a great night's sleep on a new mattress from Steinhoffels. Right now, get a Beautyrest Queen mattress for only $399. Upgrade and save up to $400, plus get a $100 MasterCard reward card with a Beautyrest Harmony Lux or Beautyrest Black mattress purchase. Harmony Lux Queens start at $14.99, and Beautyrest Black Queen mattresses start at $21.99. And with free delivery, you can't make a mistake. Only at Steinhoffels and Steinhoffels.com.
Tonight at 6:30, join me for the first annual AMIES. We'll spotlight and award female entrepreneurs in honor of Amy Gannon and her daughter Jocelyn. It's the first ever AMIES tonight at 6:30 after News 3 Now at 6.
Where have all the truck drivers gone?
There's not a trucking company that doesn't have a sign out, help wanted.
Mark Kane takes you inside a local diesel driving school to find out what's causing the driver shortage and what's being done to get them back on the road. Thursday on News 3 Now at 6.
As we look ahead through the 10-day, mild temperatures expected overall, turning above average, especially for the start of December. A little slippery early Wednesday morning with the little mixed precipitation possible, and then our next opportunity for any measurable snow will build in on Sunday. We'll be right back.
Guys, do you suffer from erectile dysfunction? Now there's great news. Peak Performance for Men will help you regain your performance and confidence naturally. Peak Performance for Men uses an advanced form of acoustic wave therapy, clinically shown to open up and regrow blood vessels, restoring normal and natural functionability where it counts most. There are no needles, no surgery, and best of all, no pain. Call now and receive an ultrasound, your initial consultation, all for free, in over $300 value. Call Peak Performance for Men today.
It's a fact. 2 out of 3 Americans who qualify for Medicare do not receive all the benefits they deserve. You could be missing out. Now, Anthem Blue Cross and Blue Shield introduces a free Medicare plan checkup to make sure you receive all the benefits you qualify for in 2022. Call 1-855-597-0884 today and receive extra benefits for a $0 monthly premium. Benefits like dental, vision, hearing, and prescription drugs. And to help you stay healthy at home, you can have free prescription drug delivery, online doctor visits 24/7, and free exercise classes. You can even receive money towards over-the-counter health items. Call 1-855-597-0884 today and feel confident you have all the benefits you deserve for 2022. You can receive extra benefits for a $0 monthly premium, like dental, vision, hearing, and prescription drugs. Call 1-855-597-0884 and make sure you're not missing out.
Welcome to the lifestyles of the smart and savvy. Today, the Coopers are a cost-conscious couple. But back in the day, now saving is more their style, which is why they chose Consumer Cellular. They get the same premium coverage as the nation's leading carriers for half the cost. Imagine talk, text, and data starting at $20 a month. And award-winning customer service. Switch to Consumer Cellular today and get $100.
I was a Navy submariner for over 20 years. I spent a large portion of my life underwater. Service is about putting your country before yourself. But Senator Ron Johnson uses his office to serve himself. Ron Johnson passed a special tax break that benefited his family's business, then cashed out of the company for $5 million. Ron Johnson has doubled his wealth since he's been elected. That's not what service is about. Tell Ron Johnson to stop voting for tax laws that benefit himself.
In today's Final Touch, monarch butterflies are beginning to arrive at their wintering grounds.
And Mexican officials are hoping for big numbers. Farmers and guides are hoping for a rebound in the number of monarch butterflies and tourists at their wintering grounds in central Mexico after a bad year for both. Officials say it's too early to calculate the number of monarchs which migrate from the U.S. and Canada each year to forests west of Mexico's capital. A formal survey will be carried out in December, but the butterflies have come to represent an important source of income for the farmers who own much of the pine and fir forests where the monarchs clump together in trees. One of the true mysteries of nature.
Wonders of nature,
absolutely. Yep.